We were getting ready to win this election. Frankly, we did win this election. We did win this election. So our goal now is to ensure the integrity for the good of this nation. This is a very big moment. This is a major fraud in our nation. We want the law to be used in a proper manner. So we'll be going to the U.S. Supreme Court. We want all voting to stop. We don't want them to find any ballots at 4 o'clock in the morning and add them to the list. Okay? It's a very sad moment. To me, this is a very sad moment. And we will win this. And we, as far as I'm concerned, we already have won it. So I just want to thank you.
President Trump just made his biggest false claim yet. He declared, frankly, we did win this election, when there are millions and millions of ballots that are still yet to be counted and many important states that have yet to be called electorally. In another maskless event at the White House that actually violates federal law because he's not supposed to have campaign events at the White House, he made a number of false and baseless claims throughout his speech. He started it by saying that a very sad group of people, referring to Democrats, are trying to disenfranchise his supporters. I want to say this plainly, and I'm not the only one saying this, but journalists and newsrooms everywhere, as well as voting rights advocates and election law experts, are trying to explain this to people, that what Democrats are trying to do is get all of the votes counted. Period. That's it. They're not trying to disenfranchise anybody or discount any ballots, but that is exactly what President Trump is baselessly claiming that they are doing. He also claimed that he won Georgia, which has not yet been called, as well as North Carolina. He's trying to muddy the waters and make his supporters believe that he is winning fair and square, so that when we do get the final vote tally, his supporters may believe that that's actually an illegitimate win. Journalists across the nation, again, newsrooms, have been trying to prepare for this for days. Trump has broadcast his strategy about casting doubt on the legitimacy of this election all year long. And actually, if you take a step back and go back to 2016, when he lost the popular vote by almost 3 million votes to Hillary Clinton, he declared those votes to be illegitimate and illegal as well, without any evidence. So it shouldn't come as a surprise that the president is doing this tonight. But after 4 years in the White House, it still should be shocking to people that he is making this baseless claim. I also want to recap for you what former Vice President Joe Biden said earlier tonight, about almost 2 hours before President Trump came out. Biden addressed his supporters in Delaware and said very clearly, asked his supporters to be patient, wait for all the votes to be counted, and said, I'm pulling up the quote, sorry. He said, it is not I or President Trump who decides who wins the election, it is the American people who decide who wins the election. So Joe Biden has been very clear that it's not his place or any candidate's place to call it, and he plans on updating his supporters throughout the day tomorrow as ballots are still being counted. Trump talked a lot about the margins that he's ahead by in key states like Pennsylvania, but there are millions of ballots that are still yet to be counted in Pennsylvania. Earlier, a Philadelphia Inquirer reporter said actually 2.2 million mail-in ballots are yet to be counted in Pennsylvania. Now, if you remember, in 2016, President Trump managed to win the Electoral College by 79,000 votes across three Midwestern states. And those states are still three of the states that we're talking about today. They're still incredibly important. So with a margin of just some 79,000 votes that he was able to get an Electoral College victory from, shows you the importance of the remaining millions and millions of ballots that still have yet to be counted. That could make a huge difference in this election. It will certainly tilt the results one way or another. And President Trump does not have evidence that these votes are in his favor. Three of the states that we're watching again, that we were watching in 2016, Wisconsin, Michigan, and Pennsylvania. And we're also watching the state of Georgia, which has yet to be called, Atlanta and Fulton County, Fulton County are still counting their ballots, and we should be able to get those results tomorrow. Wisconsin election officials said that we should have final counts out of Milwaukee by 6 a.m., so just in 4 hours, or by the time you wake up tomorrow, we should have the results from Wisconsin. Pennsylvania officials say their count may actually be the slowest one of all. It may take all the way until Friday, but they are continuing to count all throughout Wednesday, and they will provide updates. The race in Georgia has tightened, and Biden is projected to have a narrow lead there, so he could still win that state, which would be important in adding his electoral votes. So we want to pay attention to the legal challenges that Republicans make in courts if they try to take this to the courts and invalidate certain ballots. We at NowThis will be sure to bring you all the latest with that. We had an interview with voting rights lawyer Mark Elias today, and we'll be touching base with him tomorrow, I'm sure, to bring you the latest news on that front. So as we close out the night, what I want to say is I just want to urge you to be patient, trust what election officials say, trust what news organizations say, pay attention to the legal challenges to invalidate ballots, pay attention to the side that is asking for all votes to be counted, as we are in a democracy, and please try to keep that faith in our democracy. A majority of the American people still believe in our democracy, and we just have to keep making sure that our voices are heard throughout the rest of the week. Thank you so much for watching and sticking with us all throughout the night in this late, early morning. Please get some sleep, and I'm sure we'll be seeing you tomorrow.